taken.
This is high value production, and it's what Britain does best.
Lovely.
McLaren is known for success in motor racing, but this is the first sports car of their own for the general market, if you have £167,000 to spare.
What I'll do now is we'll do a lap.
Okay.
This will be what the car can do.
Okay, so this is showing off, basically.
This is showing off.
Yeah.
It's,
all right, no, well, that's potential. Good. Yeah, it looks nice.
Most of these are expected to be sold abroad. And that's just what we need, as right now we're exporting too little to pay for all our imports. To set up their new sports car business, develop the car, and build a new factory, McLaren is spending £800 million.
It's one of the quickest laps that a car can do on that circuit.
Okay. To think you could take that car on the road.
Did you enjoy that?
Very, very much. No, that is really quite...
The ride is breathtaking, but so are the financial stakes.
If it all fails, how bad is that for McLaren?
Well, putting aside the financial consequences of failure, which is always a very difficult pill to swallow, what we are is a sort of winning machine. But what we've got to be is disciplined and as focused as we are in Formula One, and, you know, we should succeed.
So what does this discipline and focus actually mean for McLaren? It's about striving to be best and high value in everything they do. Even their Surrey headquarters is not your usual factory.
Not an oil smear in sight. This is really a film set. There's no factory or any activity here at all. What was with the white corridor? I came in through a long white corridor. I went through a door, another white corridor.
So much of what comes into buildings is brought in by the human. So we clean people's feet as they come in by going down different surface finishes. But we don't only do it as regards their feet, we try and do it with their minds as well.
Level one.
Why would you expect to make a perfect product in an imperfect environment?
So why has McLaren decided to branch out from racing cars to sports cars? It's all back to the basic principles. You use the skills you've got. And in Britain, we have years of experience in motor racing. At the start of the 20th century, Britain had a speed limit of 20 miles per hour, and there was a fear that our industry would fall behind unless cars could be tested at speed. So in 1907, the world's first purpose-built motor racing circuit was built at Brooklands, just down the road from McLaren. Two-thirds of Formula One teams now build their cars in Britain. Several universities have degree courses in motorsport engineering. The industry employs 25,000 engineers, and it generates huge export revenues too. McLaren has a turnover of £250 million a year, and now it plans to leverage the wealth and expertise accrued from motor racing to create more wealth from sports car manufacture.
In 5 years' time, we intend to have a four times bigger turnover and, of course, comparable profitability to those people who succeed in this particular market. The driving force is to be the best in the world, which ultimately means you make money.
The essence of high-value production is in selling small numbers at high prices. McLaren will sell just 1,000 cars in the first year, but that's worth three times Berwyn's entire turnover on all those foreign-made suits. What McLaren does is the reverse of the Chinese model.
The skill sets that exist in our organisation and the manufacturing technologies we have don't necessarily fit into low-cost, high-volume products. They tend to be relatively low-volume with good margins, but at the same time, by necessity, they have to be world-leading products.
OK, this is really high-end stuff, but the UK is a high-end economy. Remember, successful economies always try to focus on the high value. But there's a curious effect here. As manufacturing gets more successful over the decades, the less we see of it.